A common tool used in Blackboard is the discussion board. If you have ever commented on an online video or on someone's profile on a social networking site, you may be familiar with how a discussion board works. Your instructor will tell you whether the discussion board will be used for your class. Some course sites will have a discussion board button in the course menu, but in this site, I will need to go into the communication area and select discussion board. Here you can see that the instructor has set up several different forums with instructions. For example, Forum 1 asks students to introduce themselves and list three of their hobbies. I'm going to make a post in this forum. Within Forum number 1, we can see a list of responses or threads that others have written. For example, a thread has been created here with the subject Hi. I'm going to begin making my own thread by clicking on the Create Thread button. This page asks me to enter a subject and a message, similar to an email. My subject should describe what the thread is about, so I'll put my name. In the message box, I will type my response. This forum asked participants to introduce themselves and three of their hobbies. When I am finished, I can use the spell checker to check for errors. Then post my message by clicking Submit. Clicking Save Draft will save my work as a draft if I need to finish it later. The post cannot be read by other students or my instructor until I have clicked Submit. Let's see what happens when I click Save Draft. When you save a thread as a draft, you are the only person who is able to see the thread. My draft does not show up in the list of threads. I need to go to Display and select Show All. It now appears in the list with the word Draft next to it. If this were a long list of threads, I might need to utilize the Search function in order to find and continue editing my post. I could also use the Display Drafts Only function, and this will only display drafts. I will now select my draft, click Edit, and if I'm ready to submit it, I can click Submit. I can now click OK to go back to the list of threads. Notice now that in the first forum, no threads are showing up. This is because I am only displaying drafts. I must go back to Display and select Show All or Published Only. Here's the list of threads again, and here's the thread I have just created. Now let's look at how to comment on someone else's post. Click on the thread that you want to comment on. Scroll down to see what the person has written. Let's reply to this thread by clicking Reply. Again, you can type a message. And click Submit. Here we can see the reply to the thread that we have just created. Now use the breadcrumb trail to go back to the list of threads. Notice that you can see the chain of replies for each thread by clicking on Tree View. List View shows individual threads and the number of posts. You can toggle between these two views depending on your preference. If you check a thread, you can also utilize these additional functions to mark threads as read or unread, or to flag threads to remind you to look at them later. These tools are similar to tools you would see in your email. For more help using Blackboard, contact the Blackboard Help Desk.